nanoparticles, lasers, and liquids. How do these go together? Well, like you, I'm full of questions. My name is Keith, and together we'll have a closer look into the works of Brave Analytics and their sensor platforms for characterizing nanoparticles. So, how does this whole thing work? The principle of the OF2i technology is based on a targeted acceleration of nanoparticles in liquids with the aid of laser light forces. Sounds a bit complex, I know, but let's dive into the OF2i measurement cell, where the sample containing your nanoparticles is continuously pumped through. The accurately controlled laminar flow induces precise particle motion due to fluidic forces. An OF2i-specific laser propagates through the cell and induces highly defined optical forces. So we're actually talking about particles starting to move when exposed to laser light. This is captured by a specifically developed camera system, where each particle becomes visible as a line, tracking their movement patterns 200 times per second for statistically relevant readouts. After that, the movements together with the scattering data are evaluated by sophisticated OF2i-specific software algorithms. This process allows us to calculate crucial product quality attributes such as particle size, concentration, and number-based size distribution. As if that weren't enough, all of this happens in parallel. Thousands of particles are set in motion at the same time, online, so during the production process of the actual product, and in real time. This entails that during the production process, the particle sizes and distributions are evaluated every second. The result of this patented OF2i approach as a counting method is a much deeper and representative live insight than current reference measurement methods. This guy next to me is Marco. He's one of the leading physicists at Brave Analytics and a mastermind in his field. That's why I thought I'd let him explain just what's so special about OF2i in comparison to other technologies. Hi, Marco.
Hi, Keith.
What makes OF2i technology so special compared to other measuring methods?
So there are some technologies that basically observe particles moving randomly in a fluid, which is also known as Brownian motion. OF2i, in contrast, uses actively optical and fluidic forces and interacts with particles in a certain way and manipulates them. And we have several parameters at hand to do measurements at relatively high rates.
So what is the advantage of this active principle?
So the biggest advantage is that we can measure every single particle. So in our approach, we use fluidic forces to pump particles through the cell, and we trap every single particle using optical forces. So, and the magnitude of forces acting on a particle strongly depends on the size. So with growing size, the acceleration increases too. We now can use this information and put this into our physical model to determine particle size on a single particle basis, online and in real time, just within a few seconds.
Oh, amazing. To actually realize this on a single particle basis, you're using something called the donut beam. What is this and why do you actually use it?
Yes, exactly. So we use a higher order laser mode, which basically looks like a donut that is elongated in space. And such a beam has the remarkable property that it has zero intensity on the optical axis, but also that it acts on particles in a way that they move on spiral trajectories. So now every single particle is trapped on a ring. If you now imagine a situation where, for example, cars are driving on a highway, you have multiple lanes and cars can overtake each other without crashing. So if we now take these lanes and put them on a ring, we have also our particles moving on this ring and passing each other without crashing.
Ah, amazing. Thanks for the amazing insights, Marco.
You're welcome. Thank you.
For OF2i to be used, nanoparticles in liquids are required. If this basic requirement is met, the following measurements can be performed. Particle size and particle size distribution. To be exact, a number-based size distribution, the Mercedes of knowledge in particle characterization. Count of particle density for the determination of particle concentrations, indicating single particle accuracy. Turbidity and changes in sample turbidity over time. And we are challenging OF2i to single particle analytics towards material determination, particle content evaluation, or filing status. As mentioned earlier, measurements are performed 200 times per second and analyzed every 1 to 2 seconds,
which means in the time it took me to say this sentence, we would have analyzed about 2,000 particles. That's a lot. Understanding this new principle and the idea of measuring particles based on their optofluidic induced movements is definitely groundbreaking. The approach that single particles can be measured and characterized offers a huge advantage for industrial production and basic research. The targeted optimization of particles and a complete understanding of every sample is guaranteed. Knowing how OF2i basically works and what can be measured, now I'm keen to understand where to use the technology and why this principle is worth having a closer look at.